morning, Internet. It is I, Stiv. Right? Please excuse the derisive laughter from my wife in the van. Here today to talk about one of the other challenges of living full-time in a van. And that challenge is space. Now, Gina and I have decided to live full-time in a van, so we have more challenges than people that are just doing a weekend camp expedition. So Gina went out to try and find additional storage for us in our van. What she found was this carrier from a company called Komo Creations up in Canada. I'll put a link down below at the end of this video if you want one. This is not a cheap solution, but it has been indispensable to us. The unit itself has doors that close from the front, so it lets us load equipment into the van and then close the doors. A lot of the other solutions that we found either were a trunk on the back with a lid that opened up, and Gina didn't like that because you have to lift stuff up and then lower it into the van, into the trunk, and that would be difficult for her. She's not as strong as I am. And she didn't like the ones that were a platform on the back with a lid that lowered down, because that really limits how much equipment you can actually pack in there. So what we found with this carrier, it's very nice. It has a swing out option, so this folds around behind the van. It adds about 4 feet to the end of our van. And we just put a standard wire shelf in here that lets us hold more equipment. Now you might ask yourself, self, how much equipment can I actually stow in a little carrier like this? I'm here to answer that question.
To answer the question of how much we can store in this Komo carrier, let's start with what's already in there. First of all, we put these shelves in to the carrier to allow us to pack equipment more efficiently, and so we can take stuff out of the bottom without everything falling out of the carrier towards us. This jack that we've installed at the bottom, we put out when we swing the carrier out. It's not strictly necessary, but we have this thing loaded fairly close to capacity, and when it's swung out like this, it will put some torque onto the trailer hitch. And so we just put the jack there to relieve that torque. It's also available to us if we need it for working on the van, even though with the hydraulic lift kit, that's not exactly necessary. So in addition to the jack and the shelves and to the electrical hookup materials that we have, our extension cord and our power regulator, we can also fit everything else into this carrier that you see here. Now, to give an idea what we have, let's go into the supplies that we have stored in the carrier. The first item we have is an extra solar panel. We bought this when we were originally traveling across country in an SUV to charge our Goal Zero Yeti battery. That battery now resides in the back of the van and provides us additional power that we use for charging electronic devices. And if we need to and we're boondocking, we have this extra panel to help charge everything. Over here, we have the camp rug we have to control getting dirt into and out of our van, and our camp chairs. We have the lid for our composting toilet if we need it, and we have an inflatable sleeping bag mattress in case we need to sleep outside. We have extra people with us. We of course have the bicycle helmets, our fire and water supplies. The fire supplies, we have a sledgehammer and a hatchet, which we use for splitting firewood to make kindling. We have a small shovel in case we need to use the outdoor toilet or to help bury the campfire. We have fire starting supplies, wood chips, flames, and the little color packets we like to throw on our fires to make them more interesting. We also have the rest of our electrical hookup gear. We have an extension cord with four additional ports we can plug in to the outside of the van. And we have our power adapters if we need to hook up to a 15 amp or a 50 amp circuit instead of a 30 amp circuit. We have our water hose and a water filter that we use for filling our tanks or when we're connecting to shore power. The water filter also has a pressure regulator on it that we can dial up and down so we don't end up bursting all the plumbing in our van. We also carry two collapsible buckets and one collapsible wash basin. The wash basin right now also contains our coconut core bricks for refilling our composting toilet as necessary. When you're living full-time in your van, you'll be traveling from one season to another, and we have these really annoying deflatable vacuum bags we use for storing the clothing that's out of season. So right now, it being summer, that contains our winter clothes. During the winter, that'll contain our shorts and swimsuits. We have a backpack that contains our extra electronic gear that we carry with us in case we need it. We have a cooler, we have a barbecue, we have several additional ground cloth blankets for sitting on if we want to have a picnic. We carry a caulking gun and some caulk in case we need to patch a leak in the roof or just redo the caulking to ensure we stay waterproof. This is our Wolf Wives collapsible tent. We use this when we want to move the toilet out of the van for showering purposes. It creates us an instant outhouse, or I can move it around the backside of the van and use it as a shower tent. We also have a propane grill that we use for cooking, and we've had to put an adapter on that so we can use the low pressure propane on the back of the van. We carry two electrical folding bikes to allow us to get out and about without having to break camp and move the van. We have two sleeping bags and more of our seasonal clothing. And the last thing that we carry is a 9-foot A-frame ladder, a telescoping ladder, that I can use to access the roof of the van, or we can straighten that out to make an 18-foot straight ladder that we can use if we want to put an antenna up a little higher when we're in the backcountry to try and get signal either for our ham radio or potentially our cell phone booster. The last thing that we don't carry in the back of the van in the garage is Gina. She was really whiny when I put her back there, so we decided to let her ride up front. So this is the equipment that we're carrying in the back of the van in the Komo Carrier so that we have more room for storage for day-to-day items in the van itself. Now next, I'll show you how all this stuff fits into the back of the Komo Carrier.
When you're packing the Komo Carrier, the trick to getting the maximum amount of equipment stored is put the big items in first, and then you can store the smaller items packed in around them. So, I'm going to show you really quickly how we pack the Komo Carrier. I'm going to start off with the right-hand side, the side we usually fill in first. We start by collapsing the ladder. Okay, ladder collapsed. Pull it up and then put on the strap. Now, the way the ladder is designed, we have a large bar at the bottom that keeps the ladder steady when we have it extended. That won't fit on the bottom of the Komo Carrier. So we store the ladder upside down here next to the rack. Next item to go in is the barbecue. Inside the barbecue, we have the hoses that we use, hose and extension hose, that we use to hook the barbecue up to the van. And this goes in next to the ladder and holds it in position. Next item is our solar panels. And these go in on top of the barbecue next to the ladder. Next item is our cooler. Goes on top of the barbecue. Next, two sleeping bags. A bag of winter clothing. A tent. And the final bag of winter clothing. This is the primary loadout on the right-hand side of the carrier. Okay, with this full, we start putting in some little things on this side. We have some coconut core bricks. More coconut core. More coconut core. So, with the inner side of this, with the right side of the Komo carrier full, we start packing some stuff on the side over there. Start off with our wash tub. Goes on the side over here. Our two folding buckets, which double as frisbees. Our Wolfwise shower tent. Okay, the last thing to go on the right side, we still have some space up here, we'll be able to access that even with the door closed, is my folding deck chair. And that just kind of fits in. The secret is this door has to be closed first. It latches in place. Then the other door attaches to this one. So this door has to be closed first. This is the reason we want to pack this side before the other. We push in to make it a secure fit. Pull the latches down and make sure that catches on the metal rim on each side. Okay, we're ready to start packing the left side of the carrier. We'll start with the bikes, top and bottom. First thing we do is break the bikes down. Okay, brake broken down. You pick it up. Loaded into the back of the carrier. Seat comes off, and we can drop it in on top of the bike behind there. And second bike collapsed. Throw it back to the carrier. Now, bike seat. Goes in the back. Carrier goes in the back. Our blankets. Gina's cargo bags and our little tripod stool. Gina's chair and our sleeping bag mat. entryway mat. Fire starting essentials. Go up front here where they're easy to get to. Water filter and pressure gauge adjustment and our drinking water hose. My bike helmet. Our power adapters for connecting the van, which requires a 30 amp circuit to either allow us to connect it to a 15 amp, 20 amp, or 50 amp circuit. Our water bandit for when we need to get water from a hose that doesn't have a good threading on it or has a non-standard fitting. Sand auger for tying things down. This is something we just found at a campsite somewhere. Somebody forgot it. It's now part of our kit. Go in there. An extra bike lock, so we need to lock things up. We can do that. And bike pack can go in here. Then voila. I just need to roll this back and we're ready to roll. Okay, final step to packing the Komo Carrier is to bring it back into position. Now, we can swing it farther out this way. If we want to face our campsite, we can swing it farther back in. But we have to do, move the cotter pin that's normally in there. Make sure the clamp is in place. Simply walk over. And we swing the Komo Carrier back into position. It's a little heavy, so you have to give it a little boost up the last little bit. Place the cotter pin. Cinch down the anti-vibration screw. And this is something else we've done just as a safety precaution. We have a strap, cargo strap, that we put around the back of the van. Put it into the ratchet. And we ratchet it tight. Now, when we leave tomorrow morning, last thing they'll do, take the hydraulic jack, release it, put it back into the carrier, and we will take our power setup over here, coil that up, put it back in, and that's everything we have in our Komo Carrier. Thank you very much, and I know you're all saying to yourselves, selves, how did Steve get to be so awesome? Now, don't know if I can answer that question. My wife would tell you that I'm delusional, but I think she's delusional. Thanks a lot. Look forward to seeing you again.